Hi guys, welcome to the Linux channel. So if you guys are working on Linux system software development and especially network software development, and in case if you are writing any network protocol stack, and in that case if you are writing any network protocol stack parsers and things like that, so what essentially happens is there is a case that you need to get samples of packets in binary format in case if these protocols are, you know, in case they are well established. You can have a Wireshark capture and you can even generate this sample packets via XE or something like that, and then you can continue working on your parsers, whether it is done in C or C++. So in that case, what you can do is you can you can actually export these packets in Wireshark as a raw packet dump instead of a Wireshark packet capture stored file, because it is going to store the file in you know, PC cap and formats like that. But whereas in this case we need to get an extract of a single packet. The reason of doing this is if you start writing your parsers, you can take a couple of sample packets and you can verify it is passed according to the packet header ranges and then offsets you provide, and you may have multiple headers within the same, and then you can check everything is properly parsed and stored in the data structures. In the case of C, it may be stored in a struct or any kind of data structure format you provide, so you can verify these aspects. So this video I'm going to show how you can export the same, and you can also read the contents using XSP command utility, and then you can cat the contents of the raw file. And in case if you are doing some sort of per packet encryption or per packet compression or something like that, you can get these sample packets, you can apply your compression filters along with your parsing modules. You can even apply your compression filter or else encryption filter, and you can check how far it is happening, and if it is a question of compression, you can check the compression ratios with respect to that specific packet or else packet contents, or else how to tell it is like that specific pattern as such, so to be put in a nice way. So you can confirm how exactly you are getting that compression ratios for that given packet contents or patterns inside the packet. So what you can do is, as you can see here, you can select any packet. I'm taking an example of packet of around 1500, which is the MTU sized packet. So I have captured this long ago. It's just a speed test test capture. So what you can do is you can select any of this packet, and you can come down here, and it is going to show the entire frame contents, and it is going to parse over here, as you can see here. So what you can do is you can do a right click, and you have like various options. You can also copy as a hex dump and printable dump and things like that. So this, if you do a copy of the same, you can copy in any text format file. So let me just show an example, because this video's objective is not about doing the same, so but I can just show a quick example as hex dump. So if you do that, you can open a text editor like I'm doing so and you can paste. So you can see here, it is just copied as a hex dump, but it is a sort of a string file, because it has all this as you can see here, it has all this limits which have been described, the n number of bytes. It is, as you can see here, the first byte it is starting here, and then it is starting from this 16th byte, and so on as such. But you need something different than that. If you want, you can also say copy. You can directly select raw binary, and you can go, let me delete the same, and you can paste it. Since it is a text editor, you can't do the same. So this is the reason I would like to explain. What you can do is you can directly do a export as raw packet dump. So you can see here, export packet bytes. You can select this option and you can export as a raw packet dump. So I can say this as a sample, TCP packet dot raw. So you can save as any file name, as you can see here. So once it is saved, you can go to the text editor. You can see here the total bytes of this corresponding packet. You can see here it is 1506 bytes, and since it is not a regular text file or something, you can't do a cat command. So instead you can do xsd and you can give this file name, and you hope you can see here it has parsed this packet. The contents of the packet is almost started with the first Ethernet header and so on. As such, you can see here it has started with this Ethernet header FC15 and so on. And if you verify with Wireshark, you can see here the first 14 bytes, it is this Ethernet header FC 15 so on, and it ends with this 0800, which tells us the next header is going to be IPv4 header. So the same is happening here. Since XSD is going to parse and it is going to show in this format, you can see here all the other documentation it provides. You can see here it is giving a hint that it is starting from 0 bytes, and after the first row is over, it is telling that it is starting from 16th byte, which is in hexadecimal is 10. And you can see here it is also tried like Wireshark. It is also showing any printable characters over here, and which is not a printable character, it is going to replace with a single dot or decimal. So just like any Wireshark packet capture. So you can even do a VI editor with binary option, and then raw binary file option, and then you can also edit in a VI editor. And in case you have written a packet parser modules, what you can do is you can do an fopen and you can open this raw file. You don't need to completely use any socket code or something like that. So you can use your network software which is still getting developed, and you have just written certain APIs so that you can parse this incoming packet or the frame. And what you can do is you can set the necessary offsets so that it can be parsed into the data structure, and then you can parse using this file. You can do an fopen and then you can open this file contents, and then you can read this file contents. You can pass it on your parsers and you can check whether the APIs are all in place and it is parsing the contents according to the standards, according to the RFCs, according to the protocol standards. So this way you can do your packet parsing modules. So as I said earlier in my network protocol development series, video series, I have told about the basic overall layout of a network stack. It will include a network packet parsers and then also packet generators. Apart from that, it will also include a module like FSM so that it knows if it receives a packet or else a protocol data unit, what to do with the same, and then how it sends the information to the outside world. So before I conclude this video, I would like to share about one thing is usually I take my videos at my home, as you guys know, whereas in this case I shot in a hotel room. I came for a quick 2-day religious trip to the southern part of India, and this is very much away from the place where I live, which is Bangalore. This place is called Kuke Subramanya. It is almost very religious, very holy place, which is visited by various celebrities across India. And it is having said so, it is located almost in a remote forest region. Right after some time, you can see it is almost very densely covered by a thick layer of forest, and you can see various kinds of wildlife here. And I shot some few video shots in the morning so that I can share across to my viewers. And this is a nice inspiration. If you are working in kernel space, it is always interesting that you need to understand, you need to ask yourself, or else even you are a network hacker or else a systems hacker, you need to ask various questions. Just like the movie Matrix, there is a sort of reason for any sort of existence. A process exists, there is exactly a reason for it to exist. Same way, if there is a packet which is leaving your system, If you see all the applications which you have invoked and they are not generating this packet, somehow it is getting generated and sent out of your system when you capture Wireshark. So the point is very clear. We need to analyze why it is getting created in the first place. There is a reason for it to exist. Sometimes it can be due to some malicious application which is doing it. So similarly, when you spend time with respect to these kind of religious areas, this is what it invokes. It invokes fresh inspiration. It also invokes the reason for existence, the reason for existence of mankind, humanity, and yourself as such. So I hope you like going to like my video shots which I captured in the morning. So please do watch them, guys. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.